Welcome back to the 6th Gear Garage. My 1994 Land Cruiser lost second gear, and the overdrive and ECT shift button no longer worked. Last week, I showed how to read the code for the flashing overdrive light on the cluster, and it told me the problem was the number 2 solenoid valve. Today, I'll show how to replace the solenoids inside the A442F transmission. It takes a few hours, but it's not too difficult, and I could do the job for a fraction of what the dealership would charge. So here's the shield for the transmission pan. I'll need to take that off first, and it's held on by 4 12-millimeter bolts. By the way, this isn't oil everywhere, it's fluid film to keep things from rusting. Not a problem in the south or west, but definitely a must here in northern Ohio. I try to clean any dirt around the oil pan to keep debris from getting inside while I have it apart. Next, I drained the transmission fluid. Fluid is drained. Next, I need to detach the fill tube that comes out of the front of the pan. It separates right below this bracket. But putting the pan back on with the former in place gasket sealer is actually easier if this is out of the way. And this bolt is also 12 millimeters. Here's the top of the fill tube. Oh, by the way, this is right-hand drive, so I have plenty of room to work over here without the steering and brakes. There's a couple of rubber lines to remove. They're pretty stuck on here. I can wiggle them off with a big flathead though. And I need to remove this bolt next. And this bolt is also 12 millimeters. There's 20 bolts around the oil pan and they're all 10 millimeter. I needed a universal joint to reach the bolts on the back side. I like to crack them loose with a ratchet and then remove them with the drill to save time. This has to be the worst part of all this. I'm just running a razor blade along the seam where the pan meets the transmission to cut into the sealed gasket. Each pass cuts a little deeper. And I'm doing this as much as I can reach around the entire pan. I've got a gasket scraper wedged on the back corner here between the pan and the tranny. If I angle it back, I can get enough leverage to tap it with a hammer through the opening of the cross member. It's finally happening! They must have used a lot of the form in place gasket last time it was apart. Notice, I left one of the pan bolts in on each side to catch the pan just in case it falls down. Now I'm taking the last two 10mm bolts out and the pan is finally off. Oops, I forgot to move this out of the way earlier. Again, much easier on a right-hand drive Land Cruiser than a left-hand drive. You can see there's a good amount of fluid in the pan still, and more is still dripping down. So I'm going to leave the pan sitting here to catch the drips for a bit and grab some lunch. Oh, and here are the solenoids. There's 4 going across the back. Pretty easy to swap out once the pan is off. Alright, before I change the solenoids, I'm going to do one more thing, and it sucks. But I need to scrape off the rest of the form in place gasket from the mounting surface. Basically, just do this forever until all the orange is gone. Okay, on to the solenoids. There's 4 going across the back of the transmission. The first one here is the timing solenoid valve. Then here we have the number 1 solenoid valve. Next to that is the number 2 solenoid valve, and that's the one that's not working. The last one is the lockup solenoid valve. Here's the new solenoids. I've got the lockup, the timing, and the 1 and 2 shift solenoids. These two are actually the same part. I'll start with the shift solenoids. I'm gonna replace all 4 of these while I have the pan off. They were only 50 bucks each, so why not? So I'm just using a flathead to push this harness clip out. It's all oily, so I doubt I get a good grip on it with my fingers. Then remove the 10mm bolt that holds it in. Now just pull it out toward the back. And that was messy. So I bought these from Cobra Transmission after reading online that they were the same as you'd get from Toyota. And look, Aisin and Aisin. I guess these solenoids are still used in another more modern transmission, so Toyota isn't the only source for them. Each one was like $170 from Toyota, and I paid $200 for all four from Cobra Transmission. No, they didn't give me these or sponsor the video, but I'll put the part numbers in the description so you can find them on their website and save a lot of money. The A442F transmission is known as the bus transmission on forums because Toyota also used it in a bus. Not a full-size bus, but it was something like a 30-passenger bus. But the point is, this tranny is over-engineered for the Land Cruiser, and the A442F won't have any major issues if you keep up on maintenance. So now, just pop the new solenoid in, tighten the 10mm bolt, and plug in the harness. Done. All four are the same process, so I'll do the rest off camera to keep this short. Then it's time to clean up the pan. First, I'm going to dump this old oil out. Then I'm going to scrape all this old gasket sealer off. Look here at this little magnet. Wipe it off to make sure there's no metal chunks or big shavings. There's a magnet in each corner of the pan. Here's the new form in place gasket sealer. I don't know if regular RTV is okay or not, but I'd rather play it safe with the OEM stuff than do this job twice. Notice, you only need a bead 1 to 1.5 millimeters thick. It's easy to put more on than needed. I've got my pan clean. Put the clean magnets back in. So, following the directions, this FIPG only goes on the raised area and the center of the pan edge. Make sure to go around the bolt holes. I might have a backup career in cake decorating. So that's a lot thicker than a millimeter. It's hard to apply this stuff that thin. It has to sit for like 10 or 15 minutes before installing it, so I can go clean the trans one more time. This is probably because the front of the truck is up on ramps, but I wiped this down before I put the FIPG on the pan, and it's already oily again back here. I'll wipe it down again with this towel spray with degreaser, or brake cleaner works great too. I sprayed the bolts down with brake cleaner too. So just be careful not to bump the FIPG on the edge of the pan when you're putting it back on. And the rest is pretty simple. Start with two bolts on opposite sides to hold the pan in place, and then the rest can be installed by hand in a crisscross pattern. These 20 pan bolts only get tightened to 61 inch-pounds of torque. Now, back in the engine bay, I can reinstall the dipstick tube. You can leave this in place, but I find it's one less thing to have in the way when I'm reinstalling the pan with the FIPG on it. It's a lot easier to remove on this FZJ80 because it's right-hand drive. There's less stuff over on this side. I'm just going to set that in place in the pan tube. Attach it to the intake manifold. And slide these two rubber hoses back on. And put the clamps back on. There would be a beer brake here if this was a left-hand drive vehicle. There should be a beer brake anyways. The FIPG needs to cure for a few hours. Back underneath, make sure the tubes didn't separate, and then put the lower bolt back in. Almost done. I just have to reinstall the pan shield. Four bolts. After letting the FIPG cure for a few hours, I added 4 quarts of transmission fluid. I drained about 6 or so quarts, but 4 is enough for me to start the engine, get the vehicle on level ground, and let it warm up for a more precise check. Then I ended up adding about 2.5 more quarts. Next, I went for a test drive, and second gear works again, along with ECT and overdrive. Thanks for watching. Consider subscribing for more how-to videos and project vehicle updates here at the Sixth Gear Garage.